I'd like to call the meeting of the April 13th Board of Education to order. And our first order of business is our Pledge of Allegiance. We have a treat tonight. Ms. Lacey Brown is going to help us with the Pledge of Allegiance. All stand.
I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Lacey is a second grader at Underwood Elementary and is the Miss Missouri Junior Preteen. So let's give her a hand. I would like to welcome our guests tonight. I know we have a number of guests. That's great. We appreciate you being here. Also wanted to remind you, as I have to remind myself, that we are being videotaped. So form the board from the board here. We're supposed to speak up, make sure that your microphone is on and that you are speaking into it, because we get the high sign from the guys in the back or, you know, flashing us the look at your mic sign. So we are being videotaped tonight, as we have been lately, for our public to be able to view those tapes and see what's going on in our board meetings. Okay, our first order of business is to adopt our agenda. So at this time, I would entertain a motion to adopt the agenda.
I make a motion to adopt the agenda as presented this evening.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second to adopt the agenda as presented. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Very well, the agenda is adopted. We have a number of recognitions and presentations this evening, so we'll get started with those as Dr. Benson makes his way to the podium. Scrolled too far. The first one is the recognition of our Missouri Scholars 100 students. Orley Summit, R7 School District, high school seniors were recently selected for the 2017 Missouri Scholars 100, a statewide program that honors 100 of Missouri's top academic students in the graduating class of 2017. Students will be recognized at a luncheon in Columbia on April the 23rd. Our seven students selected are Connor Lovelace, Paige Maxwell of Lee Summit High School, Stacy Edmondson of Lee Summit North High School, Colin Thompson of Lee Summit West High School. In addition, Caitlin Owens of Lee Summit North High School received the Missouri Scholar 100 Honorable Mention Award. Missouri Scholars 100 is sponsored by the Missouri Association of Secondary School Principals. Schools across Missouri are invited to nominate candidates for this statewide recognition. The selection is based primarily on a formula using the student's grade point average, the ACT or SAT college preparation score. Each nominated student had first to meet the criteria of an academic decathlon, which included 10 events designed to assure the academic strength of the student. To meet the decathlon requirements, the student must have a minimum GPA of 3.75, a minimum ACT score of 29, or a minimum ACT score of 2400, be ranked in the top 10% of the class, and have taken upper-level courses in mathematics, science, English, and foreign language. The student must also have excellent attendance and be an exemplary school citizen and be involved in school activities. Our next recognition is for Autism Awareness Month. Lee Summit R7 School District is recognizing Autism Awareness Month. The district continues its commitment to implement research-based practices to support students with autism spectrum disorder and develop meaningful instructional programs. On behalf of our entire community, we also thank our many staff members who work with students with ASD, providing a caring learning environment so students can be successful. Amy Phillips, elementary class, which is communication, learning, and social skills teacher at Prairie View Elementary, and student Ryder Gallo are attending the meeting this evening. Our next recognition is the Week of the Young Child. The R7 Board of Education expresses its appreciation to Great Beginnings Early Education Center staff members and is grateful for the important work done on behalf of our district's youngest students and their families. Heather Hamilton, special education teacher at Great Beginnings Early Childhood Center, will be representing employees at the board meeting tonight. We are also recognizing Playground Safety Week. The R7 Board of Education expresses its appreciation to the many staff members who help ensure a positive learning environment for our students, including playground supervisors. Resource Age and Facility Services, as well as employees at before and after school services and elementary schools district-wide. Prairie Ridge Elementary Playground Supervisor Christy Messerev is here to accept a certificate on behalf of all R7 employees who keep students safe on the playground. We are also recognizing National Library Week. The R7 Board of Education expresses its appreciation to library media staff members who are a foundation of our district's instructional programs. We'll be recognizing our library employees during tonight's meeting. Amy Taylor, library media specialist from Lee Summit West High School, will represent employees in the library services area. We are also recognizing Paraprofessionals Day. The R7 Board of Education expresses its appreciation to the paraprofessionals who are an essential component within our special education department, helping students be successful. We will briefly be recognizing this special day and paraprofessionals district-wide during our meeting tonight. Deborah Graham, Lee Summit High School paraprofessional, will represent employees in this area. We are also recognizing Administrative Professionals Day. The R7 Board of Education expresses its appreciation to its administrative professionals who provide essential support and expertise in school departments across our district. We will be briefly recognizing this special day and administrative professionals during our meeting tonight with Sandy Brown, Administrative Secretary of Athletics and Activities, representing all employees. Although our administrative professionals would never tell you this, they actually run the school district. As every administrator out there knows, we would be lost without those folks, including our administrative professional, Linda Ismert, who does such a wonderful job for the Board of Education. So. Linda, do we have comments from the public?
Not tonight.
Thank you. Okay, it's now time for our superintendent's report. Dr. Benson.
Good evening, everyone. It's always great to have a nice audience for our board meeting, so I appreciate everybody being here. Today's report starts with student performance. Lee Summit, our 7 school district, sponsored the annual Job Olympics, April 7th at Unity Village. During the event, 77 students enrolled in special education courses completed job-related activities such as childcare, computer skills, or food preparation. Volunteers from the community served as judges for the event, and LSR7 high school students also volunteered their time to assist with the Job Olympics. So congratulations to all of those students who participated. Also under student performance, we have high school robotics. All 3 high school teams qualified for the 26th annual First World Championship scheduled for April 26th through 29th in St. Louis, Missouri. Each team earned a spot in this prestigious competition by winning qualifying contests during the annual robotics season. This is the 5th time in 9 years that all 3 Lee Summit High Schools have qualified for the World Championships. I know these students put a lot of work and time and effort into the robotics competition, as well as their sponsors, many of whom are volunteers. So congratulations to the students. Under high qualified staff, we want to congratulate LSR7 teacher Brad Rackers. Mr. Rackers is the theater teacher at Lee Summit West High School. He's been teaching in the Lee Summit District for 7 years. In 2016, he and the LSW theater team won the best play for the production of Noise Off. Outside the classroom, Mr. Rackers organizes and serves as a mentor for the Speech Theater Association of Missouri, new teacher mentor program. He collaborates with others to create new theater curriculum focused on student performance and project-based learning. The surprise announcement was made last night at a community reception honoring 12 Excellence in Teaching Award winners and 3 Teachers of Distinction who were former Excellence in Teaching recipients who were nominated for the award again. Under governance, legislative report, on April 10th, the Missouri Senate gave first round approval to Senate Bill 313, which creates a voucher tax credit program for Missouri students in foster care, students of parents in the military, or eligible students with individual education plans under federal statutes. Initially, the bill was priced at $50 million and has subsequently been scaled back to around $25 million due to the legislative process. The bill allows voucher credits to be used in homeschools, private schools, parochial schools, public charter schools, and virtual school education options. It also has a trigger that the program would not be funded until the state formula was fully funded and transportation was funded at least 21% of allowable cost. This bill contains roughly 100 pages and includes open enrollment and student transfer legislation. LSR7 continues to oppose this bill for a number of reasons, including the voucher system's lack of accountability, the public state's budget's inability to fund the program without taking funds from public schools, and the fact that vouchers have not been proven to aid student learning. It is anticipated that Senate Bill 313 will come up for a vote as early as Tuesday, April 18th. Regarding state budget, earlier this month, the House of Representatives finalized its version of the budget for next fiscal year, and we have some good news to report on the preliminary budget. This budget, as finalized by the House, includes fully funding the state foundation formula and restores funding for school transportation, which had previously been recommended for cuts. The budget is now in the Senate, and state senators will be incorporating their budget priorities. LSR7 supports the full funding of the state foundation formula encompassed in the House, and we appreciate and support those House members who voted for that budget. House Bill 634, the Charter School Expansion Bill, is sponsored by Lee Summit Representative Rebecca Raber, has been approved in the House and was scheduled to receive a Senate hearing on April 11th. We continue to oppose this bill as written. Lee Summit Advocacy Activities. The Lee Summit Citizens Advisory Committee hosted a legislative breakfast on March 31st with approximately 45 members of the CAC and the Business Roundtable attending. Seven of our 12 area state senators and representatives were in attendance for small group discussion focused on educational topics. We appreciate the participation by our community volunteers and our elected representatives. Coming up, the CAC and Business Roundtable on April 20th will make an advocacy trip to Jefferson City to visit with our elected officials. On Thursday, April 4th, the community elected three new individuals to serve on the LSR7 Board of Education. I want to take this opportunity to express my appreciation for all 11 members of the community that were willing to run for this high service to serve the students, faculty, staff, and community. On behalf of the LSR7 administrative team, I want to offer congratulations to Jackie Clark, Kim Fritchie, and Dennis Smith as they're being prepared to be sworn in later this evening. Would you please stand and accept our appreciation? We will be scheduling a new board member orientation in the next few weeks and look forward to working with you as members of the board. That's my report this evening.
Okay, our next item of business is our Finance Committee report, so I will turn that over to whoever is reading that one tonight. Chris, do you get the honor? Yeah.
Since it's the last time. The Finance Committee met yesterday morning. The Finance Committee report, investments through March total approximately $138.1 million. The operating and revenue expense percentages are within expected budget parameters. Other finance issues, the 2017-18 human resources request, Dr. Jeff Miller shared information supporting the request for 1.25 additional FTE for the 2017-18 school year. The 1.0 FTE provides for a full-time elementary assistant principal shared between Highland Park and Lee Summit Elementary. The existing position shared by these two buildings is unable to perform certain administrative functions in the current role of administrative intern. The 0.25 FTE provides for adequate teacher coverage district-wide in the music department. Due to several retirements and the number of staff currently traveling between school buildings, staff coverage is not possible for all sections of music without the additional 0.25 FTE. These FTE additions are estimated to increase the operating budget by approximately $23,148 with redirection of existing resources and use of Title I funds. Quitclaim deed. The east section of Meadow Lane Elementary track is located on property owned by QuickTrip. QuickTrip is donating this portion of the property to the district to avoid track relocation and donating the property to the north side of Meadow Lane to adjacent residential property owners. QuickTrip has been a great partner with the district to resolve this issue with the positive outcomes for all parties involved. MIC change order number 8. Change order number 8 includes 13 items involving a variety of changes within the building, including credits for internal and external signage. The signage contracts are in the process of being rebid and will be recommended in May for approval. Progress continues on the MIC project with substantial completion scheduled for June 2017. District improvements, Lee Summit Elementary HVAC. The replacement of HVAC units at Lee Summit Elementary is part of the 2015 bond deferred maintenance scope of work and will replace 16 rooftop units and 5 conventional heating and air conditioning systems. The work was competitively bid, and the contract for award is recommended to Mid-States and Control Service Company. Flooring improvements. Annually, the district has multiple flooring projects, including carpeting, luxury vinyl tile, and resilient athletic flooring. An RFP was developed and bids received providing for unit pricing to address flooring replacement needs. The unit pricing allows for firm prices for work this summer and into the next school year as needs arise. Contracts are recommended to both FDC Contracting and Regents Flooring to provide access to vendors who can perform all flooring type replacement. Several projects will be completed during the summer 2017, including the replacement of tile in the gyms at Highland Park, Underwood, and Trail Ridge. Construction and maintenance update. Kyle Gorrell provided an update regarding the Woodland Elementary sewer. During spring break, maintenance staff scoped all vent lines at Woodland, found and repaired a number of blocked vent lines due to rust. Staff also performed maintenance to improve air quality in the kitchen and gym areas. The district is also working to address concerns by the Missouri Department of Natural Resources regarding ammonia levels at Woodland. The district is utilizing an engineer to study the issue, make recommendations, and develop options until a long-term solution is available. Clean Energy Fuel Service Agreement Modification. The current agreement with Clean Energy for CNG fueling station is recommended for modification to provide for the district's purchase of the private side infrastructure. This purchase will lower the cost paid to Clean Energy on a monthly basis while providing for an ongoing maintenance and repair of the infrastructure by Clean Energy. The infrastructure was appraised by a third party with an assigned value of approximately $1.9 million. The district purchase price is $1,686,000. Per the Board of Education's request, purchasing requested an independent inspection of the private fueling station equipment to be performed prior to the execution of the modified fuel service agreement. Clean Energy is agreeable to the inspection. The approved inspection services provider must be mutually agreed upon, with the cost shared equally by the district and Clean Energy. The total cost of the inspection should be less than $4,000. And before and after school, or BAS program evaluation, Christy Fate, the BAS assistant director, reviewed the program evaluation, highlighting the extensive programs available for enrolled students. A major focus of the BAS program this past year was on the development and implementation of STEM programming at 20 sites. The review included identification of numerous services offered to students and families at BAS that are not available at other child care programs. That is the Finance Committee report. I apologize for my froggy voice. I'll entertain any questions, and then I also have 2 motions to go along with that. No questions. First motion, 6.02. I move to approve the transfer of $2,625,322.06 from the general fund to the special revenue fund.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second to transfer funds. Is there any discussion on that motion? Hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
And the second motion, 6.03, I move to approve the treasurer's report and payment of the bills.
Second.
Bill?
I just had a quick question. Usually on the check register, there's two sets. One with, like, legal. I think we've been dividing them up, but there weren't any this month. Thanks.
Any other questions? Hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. Thank you very much. The next order of our business is our first consent agenda. As our parliamentary procedure rules provide for a consent agenda, which lists several items for approval of the Board of Education by a single motion. Most of these items listed under the consent agenda have gone through board subcommittees review and recommendation. Documentation concerning these items has been provided to all board members and the public in advance to assure extensive and thorough review. Items may be removed from the consent agenda at the request of any board member. The board, I will at this point entertain a motion on consent agenda items 6.01 through 6.22. Okay, we have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Julie?
I just want to ask a simple question about driver's ed. And wanted to know if there is a section on texting and phone calls, you know, safety in the car, proclamation to say we're not going to do it.
Actually, I'll be more than happy to ask Dr. Chad Herzog, who just happens to be here this evening, because he oversees and since Dr. Andrews is not here, who oversees our driver's education for the summer. Would you mind responding to that?
Please come to the podium.
Yeah.
Oh, we're already putting you on the spot. That's good. Get used to it.
Is it on now? Okay. To answer your question on texting, we do that. All of our drivers, each of our instructors, we have five, they all go over texting, no texting while driving with all the students. They actually make them put their phones away before they ever get into the car. So that is covered to begin with before the program begins.
But is there some kind of proclamation that they're not going to do it while they're, you know, 50 years old? And
a proclamation, no. But certainly something like that could be put into the program as part of the program. We cover it, but the proclamation is not made.
And is there any kind of video that, I mean, I just really want to stress that.
Yeah, we do videos with the students in class. That's not part of the driving portion, but in class we do, and part of that is about texting while driving.
Awesome. All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Any other questions over the consent agenda? Okay, hearing none, we have a motion and a second to approve consent agenda items 6.01 through 6.22. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Motion carries. Second part of our agenda, or the next part of our agenda, is consent. The second consent agenda, which ratify contracts that are over $5,000. And we really only have two. I believe, on this part of the consent agenda. So I would entertain a motion for approval of these contracts.
I move that the Board of Education approve to ratify contracts as presented in 7.02 and 7.03, and these contracts are over $5,000.
Okay, we have a motion and a second to approve consent agenda items 7.02 and 3. Is there any discussion on this motion? Hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. Item for decision 8 is our consent agenda for new contracts that are over $5,000. These are contracts that have been reviewed by administration and the board. but are over 5,000 but have not yet been executed. So I would entertain a motion on those contracts, and it is items 8.01 through 8.12.
Thank you. I move that the board approve new contracts over 5,000 as presented in consent agenda items 8.02 and 8.12.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Julie?
So I did a little research on this Dreambox because I've never really knew about it, but it's a math classes. And I wanted to know if all districts, all grades district-wide uses this program.
Right. Thank you for that question. It's a math program that's utilized in our primary grades. The reason it's focused just at our primary grade levels is because it focuses on number sense and concept understanding numbers in general. So it's a primary program available for all of our students. And we do have students, we are able to have students that might be, that receive special services that need to access that program, and they can also access that program as well.
So all schools, all
primary grade levels, yes.
Awesome. Thank you.
Adam?
Maybe just more of a comment. I don't know if Kyle over there, but on the flooring, so it sounds really, really boring and somewhat inconsequential, but the square footage that we're dealing with and the amount that needs to be replaced over time is tremendous, and I thought we approached it in a really efficient way by looking at bidding this according to our long-range plan. So it could have been quite costly and pretty inefficient if we'd have kind of chopped it up and done it each time as we went. So I think I might have mentioned it at Finance Committee, but I just encourage us, other things that are part of long-range planning, if there are other opportunities for us to take a similar approach. I was real happy with how the bids came back, and I think it's going to be super efficient for us going forward. So if there's other areas that we can do that on, I would definitely encourage us to look at that. But appreciate all the hard work on that piece.
I do have a question or a comment here. When I was looking through these contracts, I noticed that on the proms, that Lee Summit North's prom was $10,000 to stage and execute, and Lee Summit West's was $6,195. And the description was exactly the same in both readings. And I'm curious as to that's almost a $4,000 difference. And are they using different companies? Or does anybody know that? I was just curious, because that's a big discrepancy. Okay.
Would not know, could not speak eloquently to Lee Summit North, but at West, we've consistently used Steve Serrano and Nate as a part of our prom for the last several years. So I don't know the difference in the discrepancy between those two.
Maybe because he is a former student, he's giving you
he's been very good to R7.
A generous cut?
Okay. Yes. Steve has, yes. And Nate, too, because Nate's a former Lee Summit West student.
Okay. I was just curious when I saw the difference. That's a big $4,000.
Yes, ma'am. Sure is.
Big discrepancy, and I was just wondering what the difference was. So,
yes.
Thank you for...
We'll get you an answer to that, Linda.
That'd be great. I'd like to know that.
Thank you.
Other questions? Okay, hearing none. All those in favor of approving items 8.0, is it 1 or 2?
2.
Two through 8.12. Please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Are there any opposed? Hearing none, motion carries. And now our items for decision that are items with presentations tonight. Our first one is to certify the Board of Election Director results.
I move that Kim Pritchie, Jacqueline McIntyre Clark, and Dennis D. Smith are duly elected members of the Board of Education.
Okay, we have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? I will make a comment. Very excited about the quality of the folks that we had running for the board. Excited about those who made the final cut and were elected. We're looking forward to working with each and every one of you in the years to come while you serve your terms. And thank you so much for giving of your time to do this. It is one of the, in my view, one of the highest points of service that you can have in a community. So with that, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. The next item, item 9.02, modification to the fuel service agreement with Clean Energy.
Dr. Blevins, any comments?
No, we had a work session last month and finalized the agreement and sent that to you about 3 weeks ago and recommending for approval.
We'll entertain a motion, please.
Okay. Be it resolved that the Board of Education approve the modified fuel service agreement with Clean Energy and purchase the infrastructure for $1,686,000.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Terry?
I know we had a work session and you really explained this well to us, but I just thought it would be worth pointing out for the public that isn't able to be here this evening and that might watch this video later. This is an example of how our staff constantly is looking for alternative ways to improve our bottom line and improve our budget and allow us to put the maximum amount of money into our buildings where it impacts our kiddos. And so while we're approving a contract tonight for $1,686,000, what I think is really important to pull out of the narrative of this is it's a positive financial benefit of $1.5 million to the district. And that's because we had some staff that started asking questions and wanting to know how we could do things better. And I just applaud all of our leadership team for their ability to question the status quo and look for ways that we can save. Sometimes it's $1,000 and sometimes it's $1.5 million and sometimes it's more. But all of that goes back to our operating budget and helps kiddos in the district. So Judy and Dr. Blevins in particular, I know you had a lot to do with this. Sorry, Dr. Hedrick and Dr. Blevins, you had a lot to do with this, so thank you very much.
Thank you.
Other questions or comments? Okay, hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Okay, motion carries. The next portion of our agenda is to approve non-allocated HR positions. So, Dr. Benson.
Dr. Miller?
Dr. Miller.
I'd be more than happy to respond.
Entertain a motion?
I move to approve the non-allocated HR request positions as presented.
Second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? I would comment that as we move closer to the end of school and closer then to the beginning of our next school year, you will see some fluctuation in our staffing due to the fact that those numbers are a little fluid. And as we go through there, we see or recognize that there are significant changes in our clientele, in our number of students that we have, movement between schools and from and away, movement within the staff itself. So you might see additional requests come through. Some of those are extra that we planned for, and some are accounted for in the original estimates that we looked at as we went through our budgeting process. So it's just that you'll probably see those for a while yet, and maybe even as late as August and even September. Sometimes that happens.
Bob, I'd like to comment that I'm really happy to see another employee hired in as a music instructor, because those instructors, they travel, some of them building to building to building, and some of them kind of feel homeless at times because they're not sure where they're based. And I was just really happy to see that on the schedule. I just wanted to thank you for that. That's great.
Okay, are there any other comments or questions? Hearing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. And our last item is, again, to Dr. Miller, our personnel report.
Absolutely. It's a busy time of year for human resources, and I would just entertain any questions that you might have, and then by all means, I would also like to recognize some folks here in the audience, if the board would so desire.
I just wanted to comment, Dr. Miller, thank you for pulling out retirement, those retiring into their own section. Thank you so much. That really helps understanding where everybody's going and those special retirees. It's really great.
You're welcome.
Thank you for doing that.
Motion, please.
I move to approve the personnel transactions as presented.
Okay, we have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion or comment on the motion? I would like, Dr. Miller, could you please tell the audience and the board when the teacher retirement reception is?
I believe it's going to be May the 4th. I want to make sure. I've got it on my computer, just a second. Hang on, I'm looking it up. It's actually the 2nd. My apologies for that. It's May the 2nd, which is a Tuesday. And I believe that's from 4:30 to 6:30. And by the way, we have 101 staff members that are retiring this year.
Wow.
I thought I would just share that.
That's a lot.
We're normally in the 80s, depending upon the year, 80s, but this is the most in my 7 years in this position.
Dr. Miller, how many are you anticipating filling? How many new teachers do you see coming in?
At this point, we're planning on filling all those positions back, as when you look at our student needs and our growth, et cetera, we're planning on filling every one of those positions back. It may be a little different based upon student needs as far as exactly what the assignments are, the buildings or the grade levels, et cetera, but we're not anticipating at this point cutting any FTE.
Wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you.
And I would imagine, Dr. Miller, that you have filled some of those positions and some you're still working on. So I might give a word of advice to anyone in the audience or who will see this video, that if you're considering a teaching position, at least some of it, don't give up hope. There are positions. It just may take a while. So keep hanging there.
Absolutely. Mm. Great point.
Okay, we have a motion and a second. If we could... have all those in favor of the motion, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? All right, our motion carries.
Personnel introduction?
Yes. Dr. Miller,
absolutely.
Please.
It's my pleasure I want to recognize five individuals, two of those individuals are here. First and foremost, I want to recognize Chad Herzog. Chad Herzog is currently an athletic director at Lee Summit High School. Chad's been employed in the district since 2002 has been a teacher, assistant principal, and once again, as I said, athletics activities director in his current position. He's also a graduate of Lee Summit High School, he is going to be just a tremendous addition at Lee Summit West as the new principal at Lee Summit West High School, home of the Titans. As Dr. David Sharp, our current principal there, is moving into a new position next year at Central Office and will be the Assistant Superintendent of Secondary Instruction. So we're very pleased by this selection. We're very pleased by having someone who's going to lead that building and continue to grow and do what's best for kids down there. So Chad Herzog, congratulations. And as a result of moving Dr. Herzog over to Lee Summit West, that created a couple of changes you may have seen in the report. While neither one of these folks are here, I want to recognize them because, number one, of their professional contribution. Tracy Bertonson is moving from assistant principal, her current role this school year, at Lee Summit High School to fill Dr. Herzog's position. She will be the new activities athletic director at Lee Summit High School. And then James Euler, who's currently an intern assistant principal at Lee Summit High School. And this was the purpose of this role. And I think I want to say once again, thank you to the board for being supportive of this role. James is going to be moving into Tracy's position as assistant principal. So while there he will definitely miss Dr. Herzog, Tracy Bertans will be moving over, will be the activities athletic director, and then James Euler will be moving up into the assistant principal position, and we will be posting internally the administrative intern position at Lee Summit High School. And then the other person who is here tonight that I'm really excited about, and that's Mr. David Mitchell. Mr. David Mitchell is going to be the new principal at Summit Lakes Middle School, home of the Falcons. And this is someone who comes with not only a wealth of experience, but also the data-proven leadership. David is currently the principal at Raypec East. He's been in that position, I believe, since 2006. Prior to that, he was principal at Bingham Middle School in the Independent School District. So he's bringing with him 14 years of administrative experience as a middle school principal. He's a proven leader. I know that the staff's excited about him joining the team down there. And so welcome, Mr. Mitchell. You'll please stand. And then last, but certainly not least, we are very excited, and after a long search, to be quite honest, to be introducing, although she can't be here tonight, Dr. Jennifer Corum. Dr. Jennifer Corum is currently the executive director of elementary education in the Liberty School District. She's been in that position since 2014, and we know about the accolades that Liberty has going on at the elementary level. Prior to that, she was the director of curriculum at Park Hill from 2010 through 2014. And then prior to that, she had 4 years of building principal experience as an elementary principal, both in the Park Hill and Belton School District. And she sends her regrets. She was able to be here tonight due to a prior commitment, but she will be taking, well, Dr. Katie Collier's current role as the assistant superintendent of elementary instruction. She'll be leading all of our elementary buildings and just doing a tremendous job. And so when you think about our instructional department, I can say I'm very excited about Dr. Collier moving into the role as Associate Superintendent of Instruction and Leadership. Dr. David Sharp coming into the new role there as Assistant Superintendent of Secondary Instruction. And then Dr. Jennifer Corum coming in as the new Assistant Superintendent of Elementary Instruction. When you think of the A-team, I can't think of anything better than those three right there. So really proud of that. Congratulations to all involved. And I think our district, once again, has hired the best, and our kids are going to be in great hands. Anything else you want to add, Dr. Collier?
No, very excited about the leadership. Certainly all those that are involved in the changes are ready to begin those transition plans, make sure that everything is seamless for all of those that we serve. So we're just really excited.
Thank you, Dr. Miller. Dr. Collier. The next item of business is a presentation from before and after school program evaluation.
No, it's not on. Okay, thank you for having me tonight. My name's Christy Fate. I'm the assistant director for before and after school services. Dawn Butler Cry is unable to be here tonight. She's the director of our department. And we just want to thank you for allowing us to come in and share with you about our department, our various programs that we have. And I also want to say that we have some friends from our one from our department. Her name is Tracy Holder Turwey. She's one of our program managers, so I'll have her stand up real quick. And then also Kale Holder, he's a student at Lee Summit West, and he can stand up real quick too. You'll know why he's here in a few minutes when we get to that part of our presentation. So I'll just jump right in. The slide that you see there is of all of our programs that make up before and after school services. We are excited. We're celebrating 20 years We've been most recognized for Kids Country, but we do have our KC Cubbies program, which is our pre-K kids. They are 3 to 5 years old. They are awesome and super cute. Kids Country there, the second picture, is in all 18 elementary schools before and after school, and most non-school days we're providing care for kids as well. And then Summit Rise, if you're not familiar or you don't have an elementary child in our schools, is our Late Start program on Wednesday mornings, where we provide care to anybody in the elementary age that needs care before school starts later in the day on Wednesday. So we average about 2,000 or so students every Wednesday. And then Three Links is our middle school program that also provides services all the way up through age 21. And that would be students that are qualifying students for special services in our district, the ones that would attend through age 21. So that's kind of all of our programs. This next slide here. We had a department goal this year to really dig deep and try out our hand in STEM, and that's science, technology, engineering, and math. Many times you'll see people are kind of nervous to jump into those kinds of activities thinking, I don't know anything about science, technology, engineering, and math. And we had so much fun this year with that. Staff spent lots of time preparing activities and researching and getting things ready for the kids. We started out at the beginning of the year by setting up a clubhouse in each school where kids could do basically self-directed activities that were available to them. And then all throughout this year, we've offered at least once or twice a week some activity that's in that area of science, technology, engineering, and math. And those were activities that were actually led by the staff in our programs. And then at the end of this year, right now we're in the middle of all of them, the family celebrations that are occurring at each location, and parents get to come in and actually experience some of the activities that the kids have gotten to do. I don't know if you can see the pictures well enough. They're kind of small, but we wanted a lot on there. They've done everything from making it rain in a cup to volcanoes to coloring spaghetti, lots of fun stuff. So we're excited about that. Now, what I'm going to show you next is the part that I'll introduce Cale again, but he did a film project that he took footage at Meadow Lane, Sunset Valley, and Longview Farm, and lots of variety of STEM activities you'll see in the video, as well as some interviews of the kids and the staff at Kids Country. And so Cale did this for a project. He's a junior at Lee Summit West, and it's for the advanced video tech class there. So we thought that would be neat to tie that in for his school and for us. So we really appreciate what you did for us and your expertise in that. So I'll go ahead and start the video.
Scale, but we teach it in a fun way and to appropriate.
Anyway, over the past year, we've had some discussion about our rates being kind of in the upper, probably about the third. We do a daycare or childcare survey every year, and our rates have kind of moved into that upper range of about the top third in the area. And that's, you know, somewhere we don't want to be in that upper end, but we wanted to let you know there are some reasons why we might be in that area to some degree. And the points that you see up there in the list that are highlighted with an asterisk, we've done some research, and those are items that you won't find standard in other area child cares. And so that can help, you know, to understand why we might have slightly higher rate. We do strive to provide exceptional care for students regardless of their abilities, and sometimes that does come at an additional cost. But we do work very hard and work annually and actually monthly with Dr. Blevins and Dr. Hedrick in providing a strong, balanced budget and while still maintaining really high quality standards for our kids. The next slide kind of breaks down our financials for the past 5 years, and you can see on that far right column our revenue there is $2,998,680. That's what we're projecting for revenue. Expenses we're projecting for the end of this year at $2,942,289, which leaves a variance showing up, we're predicting a positive year-end balance this year of $56,391. So under that chart, you can see over the last 5 years, annually our rates have gone up each year approximately 2.4%. And then we are not projecting an increase in rates for next year. Because our cumulative balance, you can see there's about $1.5 million. Our efforts are going to be focused on no rate increases and maintaining our balanced budget, as well as continuing to provide that quality care for our kids. And then finally, we just want to say thank you to you, the Board of Education, for your tireless efforts to provide what you do for our district, and it's very much appreciated. We'd also like to thank the many departments that you see in that list up there as well, because it's the collaboration and the support. We are connected with almost all of them on a monthly basis, and without that support, we wouldn't set ourselves out in the child care world that we do. So, thank you for letting me share tonight. That is the full presentation for this evening. You will receive our full program evaluation, I think, after this meeting. So, do you have any questions?
Chris?
Yeah, I was curious. Did you guys have anything planned for the 20th anniversary? Our 20 years now, any special celebration or whatever?
Well, we've kind of been celebrating all year with our team. We plan to do a special celebration at the end of our year. We've got some shirts out there that celebrate 20 years, and then we've got our end of the year celebration coming up in May.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, written reports are the only one we have tonight. It's submitted by our construction and maintenance update, and that is usually covered fairly well within the scope of our finance report. Does anyone have any questions for Kyle on the construction and maintenance report? Okay, well, hearing none, we will proceed to our roundtable discussion. We're going to start with Julie. I'm going to have you start.
All right, thank you. I normally give at least some a CARES update, but I'm going to focus my minutes on the three leaving up here. And I want to say to Terry, thank you for your community service on the board and the CAC and everything you've done with that. I appreciate it. Chris, most of you do not know that Chris and I mostly see things eye to eye. So sad to say that publicly. But, so I will miss you, and I will also miss having a tightwad on my tightwad cohort. Bill,
Thank you for challenging me in some ways, and I hope I challenged you in others. And as Dorothy said to the scarecrow, not that you don't have a brain, okay? Because I know you do. I think I will miss you the most.
Thoughts?
Okay, several things. Get my microphone turned on here. Next Thursday, a week from today, is a legislative trip to Jeff City. If anyone out there has not signed up, please do so. It is always a informative, exciting time for us to go down there and speak with our legislators. Today I had the opportunity, kind of happened accidentally, to tour the MIC with Lieutenant Governor Parsons. And I reminded him that Lee Summit would be coming down next Thursday and we would be dropping in and saying hello. A lot of the issues that you've heard about tonight are very near and dear to all of us. Again, I'm a big advocate, proponent of public education, and we'll be down there speaking that language very loud and clear next Thursday. MIC looks fantastic. I missed the walkthrough with the board 2 or 3 weeks ago because I was busy in my business. So yesterday at Teacher of the Year, I said to Lane Metcalf, I'd love to, next time you're in the building, let me know. I'd love to come and join you. And she said, tomorrow, 3 o'clock, we're going to do a walkthrough. So it was fantastic. I beamed with pride at having this in our community. It's a one-of-a-kind in the nation, and I hope that everyone gets a chance to see the facility at some point. It's fantastic. One of the things that I really want to commend us on is the upkeep of our aging buildings in our district, such as Miller Park, Greenwood, some of those schools, and that was something that Lieutenant Governor Parsons said to me today as we were talking for a brief moment, how he was impressed how we are keeping our aging buildings looking great. And that's the truth. You can walk into any of our older schools and they look great. They still have that smell of character and charm, but they look great. And that's really great that we continue to improve them alongside new buildings. Let's see here. Teacher of the Year yesterday, I have the opportunity to work on this committee for about 7 years. It really is probably my favorite thing that I get the opportunity to work on is interviewing, reading hundreds of applications, and then interviewing, narrowing it down to 12, and then interviewing for those 12, interviewing those people. I'm reminded how profoundly awesome our staff here is. And the big note that you can draw up on all these interviews is relationships, relationships, relationships. As a person who's lived here in Lee Summit all of my life, that's where I'm at today, is because I've maintained relationships with people I went to school with, college with, cheered with, danced with, etc. So I'm really, really proud of our teaching staff and really proud of Brad Rackers, who was selected as Teacher of the Year. He did an outstanding interview, and Julie's nodding her head. We were on this committee together, and it was fantastic. To Terry and to Chris, you were my role models. You are my role models when I joined the board in 2012. I felt leadership coming right at me, and you've both been outstanding. I look to my right and see a very strong, intelligent, articulate woman that I've looked to for many, many, I've had many questions through the years, and you've answered those for me, and I wish you nothing but the best. I think you are the best. I really do. Right here next to me, he gives me trouble. He likes to give me trouble. I've known Chris for a long time. His niece danced with me through my program, so I got to know him through dance competitions. And then when I was seated up here with him, he still gives me trouble. But these are two of the finest here in the community, and I hope that tonight you will all take the opportunity to thank them for their service. They're outstanding human beings and wonderful leaders in our district. Mm-hmm. I want to leave it at that. Mm-hmm.
Adam.
I want to thank all of the board candidates. Obviously, congratulations to the three that were successful and will be welcoming to the board today. But we were lucky to have more than just three great candidates, and it was really exciting, mostly because I wasn't participating as a candidate, really exciting to watch and to see so many people be up to the task. And, you know, so all candidates who participated deserve to be congratulated. It was a very informative and engaging experience, I think, throughout the campaign, and I see at least one candidate here as well beyond the three that we're going to be welcoming tonight, so wanted to thank everybody for doing that. I feel underprepared. I don't have one single Wizard of Oz quote to give to, I mean, that's, I guess, I should have known better, but I won't do individual thank yous because then I'll get emotional and I'll start crying, but I think we were lucky to have all three of these board members sitting because the variety of qualities, perspectives, experiences that they brought, I think, was able to get us to where we are today. So just want to thank them, and I'll yield the rest of my time to Phyllis. Looks like she wants some more roundtable back, but it was a pleasure serving with the three of you. And
I do want the roundtable back for a second. Because I've got these two down here, I forgot about the very special man sitting at the end. I'm sorry. He's been my partner in crime and so many things in the community, and you've inspired me. I've learned a lot, and I wish you the very, very best, and I'm going to miss you on this board.
Bill.
I've been dreading this night for a while because I didn't know what I would say here. So I had to write it out, similar to what you did. So I'm just going to read it, and I want to talk to the, I want to say some things to the board and the staff and the community and new board members. So forgive me for reading most of it. But over the last year, I enjoyed the way Chris Storms and I helped drive healthy discussion for the board. It was interesting to see as often we take off on alternate routes, but we'd always reach the same destination. And Chris, you're an understanding person and a passionate advocate for the schools and for the community, and I learned much from you. I thank you for your years of service, and I'm really pleased to be able to call you my friend. Thank you. Adam has more empathy than nearly anyone I've ever met. He is a peacemaker and a phenomenal collaborator. Adam, in your continued service, there may come a time where you have to follow your heart and your integrity and go the path less traveled, and I want you to know that I trust your heart and your integrity, and I'll be all right if you go a different direction. So thank you for your service. Terry is so empathetic and yet analytical, and she's compassionate but fierce, and so she is someone you absolutely want on your side rather than against you. And Terry, I really do wish we could have been on the same side more often because we could have moved mountains together, and I do wish you the best as well. No person could have brought this board together like Bob White did this year. He made a lot of sacrifices for this board, for the school district, for the community, and his family. I've always been an admirer of Bob White, but this year I became your number one fan, so thank you for all you've done for us. And also thank you for making sure we all have a voice on this board and helping us work through those issues this year. What a great face and voice Phyllis Belagna is for this board and community. She is a lighthouse in the midst of a storm and a rainbow on a cloudy day. Phyllis gave me the strength in the best and worst of times. I look forward to supporting you in all your endeavors in the community because you are and have a special place in my heart too and are truly a difference maker. And then it takes a long time to find a lifetime friend, or it takes a lifetime to find a friend like this amazing and strong lady, Julie Doan. I will forever be grateful for your friendship. Please continue to provide the reasonable, your reasonableness and your moral compass that helped guide me over the last year, and keep asking the good questions. I do have a few tips for you in your continued service. First, your sarcasm needs to come with a caption for the new board members, because it took me 2 years to figure out what you were that you were trying to be witty. And secondly, your silly jokes are somewhat tolerable in the work sessions, but not in this boardroom, because there's a video, okay? And then I do have one more for her, which is lose the evil eye. Lose it. But in all seriousness, thank you for your support and becoming one of my dearest friends. I will always be thankful for Dr. Benson for coming to this district. This community may never know what all you did, but we know, I know. I've known some 5-star professionals and leaders in my career, and you, sir, are the cream of the crop, and I cannot thank you enough, so thank you. I do want to throw a kudos out there to, if you want an attorney that cares, Joe Hatley is your man. He brought clarity and objectivity to this district. He's diplomatic. He's a problem solver. I can't believe some of the skills you have. I just wish you weren't such a great debater, because I lost to him many times. Thank you again, Joe. This one's the hardest one. It's to the staff of Central Office. It may have felt like I was fighting with you at times. However, I would like you to know that I've always felt that I was fighting for you. And I understand why many of you may not believe or understand that, but it's true. And I would like to thank those that offered a friendly exchange or a warm, embracing smile, even in the most difficult times, because it meant the world to me. And Linda Ismer, someone once told me that you have a heart of gold, but that does not do you justice. Thank you for all you have done to make this district better. My tenure the last 18 months as a board member was one of great stress, and had it not been for the staff and the teachers, the school district lifting me up and giving me strength, I wouldn't be here today. And I wish I could thank each one of the teachers and the bus drivers and everyone out there, but they know who they are. I do love this community. This community is where I live. It's where I raised my children. I raised them already. Wow. And why I will continue to be an activist, and it's the people. That's what makes Lee Summit wonderful. Most of the citizens in our community, though, are just now finding their voice, and I'm proud that they found their voice this year. They did make a difference. You made a difference, and no one else can take credit, nor deserves the credit. So I see with this election, you see the people that came out here. We've got these unbelievable new board members coming on the board. The caliber of this group is phenomenal. And I think that you know, Lee Summit needs to continue to advocate for the community, needs to advocate for good causes and come together for the betterment of all. And as the board members takes office, I do thank you for answering the call to duty. I'm just very proud of you. I would like to remind you, though, that this board is a reflection of the community. We did come together this year for the betterment of all, and I'm very proud of that and this board. As a school board member, I was proud to represent this community. However, I took my duty to heart. Everybody knows this, and I woke up each day knowing my responsibility and the magnitude of my decisions. We're elected officials and entrusted to provide vision, set policy, and govern. It's our duty to provide vision, even if we must interject it. It's our duty to set policy, even if it means doing things that a different way, and to govern, even if it requires asking the most difficult questions. So please, new board members, never hesitate to ask a question concerning our mission, our policies, or our governance. Do so with professionalism and without remorse. And lastly, leave the operations to the most capable staff that we have here. Just make sure our kids are safe. And the last person I want to... thank is my most supporting wife, Hillary, who's here. Thank you for supporting me throughout the term, and it was at times harder on her than me, so thank you. All right, and that's all I have to say. Thank you.
Thank you. Terry?
I started out tonight trying to think of how I was going to thank everybody, and then I looked at the personnel report, and I looked at the recognitions, and I decided I was opting for a no-name policy tonight. So for a number of you, for Teacher of the Year, I wanted to congratulate a number of staff that are moving on to positions of more responsibility. Normally, I use this as an opportunity. I'm just going to be neutral and no names tonight, because I want everybody to know I appreciate them, but I wanted to point out a few things as I look back on the last 6 years that I've been on the board. Some in this community have claimed that this school board has been self-serving and approved items brought to it with a rubber stamp for the past 10 years. And my perspective on that is a little different. I wanted to share with you some decisions that I have seen made during my 6 years on the board, but also during my previous involvement with the Citizens Advisory Committee, that were based on very thorough decision-making processes and recommendations that came from all levels of leadership within the district. I remember sitting in the first work session we had as the pilot for the Missouri Innovation Campus program came, and walking out of there with tingles going up my spine for the program we were starting for those kids. And that was not one person's idea. That was the idea of many, many dedicated staff and teachers and professionals, not only from R7, but also from the University of Central Missouri. They came together, they tried a pilot, it worked, they found funding, and now we're going to have a new facility, we're going to be able to scale that program, and we're going to have kids like the video tech presentation we saw tonight, really be able to accelerate their careers. The program has worked, and I'm excited that that has come forward in the last few years. We did get to tour the building in an early hard hat tour, and despite all of the rough edges that are still there in the building with no finishings, I know this community is going to be so proud of that facility when it opens. It's fantastic, and as I think Phyllis said, it's going to be a national model, and we already have kiddos graduating as seniors in high school with full-time job offers and offers for paying for their college, and they are accelerating their careers because of what we're going to be able to provide to them. The one-on-one technology initiative was not supposed to be a one-on-one technology initiative, but the process action team that put that together and studied it for months came down to a few months before it was supposed to be rolled out, and they said, we can't do two-to-one at one level and one-to-one at another level, and they found alternative sources of funding in the budget. They worked together as a team to bring forth to the board a very aggressive plan to put Chromebooks in every student's hand in a true one-to-one. I'm amazed at the speed with which this team worked to get that done. And I think, you know, every new program has bumpy starts every once in a while, but this has been a phenomenal success. We converted our aging bus fleet from to a compressed natural gas, and as you saw tonight, approved a contract to even further improve the financials of that program. Again, a very diverse process action team worked with all levels of staff to make that happen. And I think, especially, I have two kiddos with asthma, and I greatly appreciate that they don't have to smell those fumes every day as they're on the way to and from school. And I will tell you, their asthma has not been acting up as much in the last couple of years they've been on a CNG bus. Anecdotal, I know, but I know that we've done a good thing for our community, our kids, and our environment. We made some really tough cost containment decisions early in my board tenure, and you know, I'm glad to see that we've been able to put some of those back. I hope we will continue to look at that. But again, that was a process. PTA members, parents, staff, administrators, they came together and they ranked what items that we were spending money on that we needed to be a little bit frugal with during a very tough economic time. We made it through that tough economic time. We have a good fund balance now because of the work of that cost containment team and the ongoing work of the very qualified staff that we have. I've been involved with too many bond issues to count. I lost track and didn't have the energy to look them up, but I enjoy driving by schools and seeing new playgrounds and buildings where I can tell the parking lot's been done, and I know that the teams, the facilities master planning team and the Citizens Advisory Council and others, they would have helped rank those things for us and help us plan our bond funding very responsibly, have a lot to do with those. We've reviewed hundreds of board policies. Those, as we heard tonight in our work session, go through a rigorous process of staff recommendation, legal vetting, conversations with Missouri School Board Association. We've made this board and district, this board has made this district stronger because of all the hard work that's been done for years. And then I think probably the one that hits me the most right now, because I have an elementary student and a high school student, is curriculum realignment. I'm having to Google stuff that they ask me about homework all the time, but I know that our curriculum has been aligned, and we are really preparing our kids for the future. And that, again, was a strong team from across all grade levels, across all buildings, that came together and looked at our curriculum and continue to look at our curriculum to make sure we're fulfilling our mission and helping each of our kiddos prepare for success in life. Not all the decisions have been as public, though, and I want to give you an example of one that we worked on that never hit the dais up here. It was a decision that a process action team was formed because there was a vision that maybe we could be the school district that had the first ever totally virtual high school. It was kind of an interesting idea. It would have made us a really forward-looking district. And so we put together a team, again, across grades, across buildings, across different departments. We went out to schools. We talked to teachers. We talked to students. We talked to parents. In the end, that decision wasn't a good decision. Our district, our community, was not ready for that. We realized, and the kids told us loud and clear, they want that building. They want to be able to participate in sports and see the kids, their friends, in between schools. So that's an example of a decision that went through that same process and came out with a non-recommendation that, again, I ramble, I know, but it's just a partial list of the decisions, and I don't see any of those as rubber stamp decisions. I see those as decisions, and I am very proud of the work that the staff in this district has done and continues to do every single day of the year to make sure our district operates efficiently and effectively, and that the board is presented with well-thought-out and thoroughly vetted recommendations. I have not agreed with every recommendation that's been presented to us. I have not agreed with every decision that this board has made during my 6 years. They have supported those decisions for the good of the district and the good of the student out of respect for the process that's there. To the incoming board members, I wish you the best of luck. You're starting on one of the most difficult, but one of the most rewarding volunteer experiences you'll ever have in your life. And I don't regret 1 minute of anything that I've done in my involvement with the school district. A couple of thoughts I'd like to offer for you. First of all, remember what makes this district great. It's not the Board of Education. It's the staff and the teachers and the bus drivers and the cafeteria workers and the maintenance crew. It's every one of those thousands of people that touch our children every day and contribute to this community, not only in school, but out of school. This is not about the board. Your service is about the community and the students. We owe our community, and our community owe our staff and teachers a great debt of gratitude. More importantly, I'd like to remind all board members that you are part of a board team that requires communication, collaboration, transparency, and honesty. You must work together to provide the staff with the support and policy guidance they need to continue their excellent work. The well-being of our district relies on a unified, fair school board, one that operates as a whole, regardless of the individual opinions or agendas of any one individual member. The only thing that I hope is that you can work together to form that bond as a new school board. It will be tough with 3 new board members coming in. Spend the time. Build those relationships, get to know each other. Thank you for letting me play a very small part in the history of this school district. I appreciate everything that you each do for this school district and this community. Thank you.
Chris?
Well, I didn't write anything out because if you know me, I'm not good at that. I'm better at flying from the hip. So my time in the district, it's kind of all wrapping up here in the last few months. Because I got involved with the Lee Summit Schools when my oldest son was in kindergarten. And I was single dad at the time. And kindergarten, and I thought it was crazy that we didn't have all-day kindergarten. And I saw that there was a team being put together to study all-day kindergarten. So I signed up for that team. And we talked about this yesterday at our finance committee meeting. I thought I saw Carrie Boehm up back there earlier, but I think maybe she's gone. But Carrie was on that team when we did all-day kindergarten study team. But that kindergartner, my oldest, is now finishing his sophomore year at Missouri State. That's how long ago that was. We did that in the 2002-2003 school year, and our team recommended that we implement all-day kindergarten. It was about 8 years later before we finally were able to put the dollars together and implement all-day kindergarten throughout our district. And it seems like we've had it for years, but it really is only, it's not been that long. It's only been a few years, and we had to make a lot of changes to do that. And then, you know, then from there, served on another committee, 6 years on CAC, various committees throughout the, you know, throughout that time. Apart from the school district, like Building Our Future Committee, Coalition for Excellence in Education, various things that just the real reason was for my two boys. And so, in that, my youngest now, he's a senior. So, I'm wrapping up my school service because my kids are out of school. But it's kind of neat the way some things have come together. Just various things, people that I've met, become friends with. Even yesterday, it was kind of interesting because one of, like you have. So one of the teachers that was up for Teacher of the Year was Pam Hayes, and second, I owe a lot to Pam Hayes. Not only she was both of my boys' kindergarten teacher. Like I said before, I was a single dad. When my youngest was in kindergarten, she set me up with my wife. and we were talking about that yesterday, and Pam said that was her only success she's ever had in setting somebody up. So, and my wife is here, and much like Bill, my wife has stood behind me and everything in my 6 years of being on the school board. And when I was on CAC, being that she's a school teacher, sometimes it was very difficult because she did not agree with everything that we were doing. And we would just have to agree that we didn't speak about things. And most of the time, you know, just because of the board and just confidentiality, I couldn't even share things with her who was in my own household. And I share everything with her. And so I wasn't able to do that, but she's, you know, she stood behind me, no matter what those decisions were as we, you know, went along the way. But again, our staff, I've been down to MSBA every year, and I can tell you, I talk to people from other school districts all across the state, and there is no better staff than what we have here, and it's because of our community. They're great people want to come to this community to work, and from everybody that you see up here. And I was just thinking earlier today, in my 6 years on the board, the positions of our top leadership, we've changed twice. The secondary education and elementary education. And we've changed all those twice now, and have had good people. And Judy Hedrick, there's no smarter business person that knows school finance in the state of Missouri, none. And Brent Blevins, we've been lucky to have him for the last 3 years, and he's moving on to a great new gig that he's got. But so he'll still be around here, and his kids will be in this district. And just like Bill said, Linda Ismert is the best secretary of any of the board secretaries in the state of Missouri, and is a wonderful lady. And Dr. Benson, thank you for coming here and helping us out this last year. It's been worth a lot to us. And Jeff Miller. I had the pleasure of serving with Jeff on Team Lee Summit. He's a good leader, and I often felt, being on the school board, that we didn't make the most important decisions. The most important decisions were usually coming out of Team Lee Summit, and Jeff is the guy that leads that group. Amazing group of staff members that do a lot of good things. As a board member, there's a lot of times where I felt, you know, I've always, it was about the kids, but really when you do stuff, I felt often like CAC, I did more on CAC than I did as a board member. You know, you get to know more stuff and do more stuff, but good things come out of those other groups that we have out there. It's well worth it the way that the district operates that way. Lastly, my board members, Terry, you have the best heart and the heart of gold, and I know that much like me and my two boys, your two girls are your purpose in life, and seeing them through and making sure that your school district is the best school district. I appreciate that. Phyllis, there's no bigger cheerleader in the city of Lee Summit. No bigger cheerleader. Not just for the school district, but for the city as a whole. You will never find anybody that will cheer for this city across the country like Phyllis Bologna does. The only problem is just make sure you don't give her the microphone because you might not ever get it back. Bob White. When I my first 2 years on the board, I looked to Gene Brixey as my mentor, and really think the world of Gene. But even though I was on the board for 2 years longer than you, after Gene was off the board, I really looked to you as my mentor, because there was a lot of difficult times that you guided me through. And you know this district probably better than just about anybody else because you've been here so long, and I appreciate you. Adam, no matter what room we were ever in, I always felt like you're still the smartest guy in the room, and I mean that as a compliment. I have always appreciated your wisdom, and I've said that as a 51-year-old man, there's a lot I can learn from a 33-year-old guy, and I have over the last 2 years. I've learned a lot from you, not just in about school stuff, but just in discussions we've had even about business life and, you know, talking about things, and I appreciate your wisdom. Bill, even though we didn't always agree, like you said, we always came together, and you know, even though sometimes we go about things differently, and I may have done it differently than you, I know you always had the best interest in what you felt was right. And I, no matter if I disagree or didn't disagree, we usually did. But if it's what you feel right and what you fight for, you got to respect somebody for that, you know, as much as anything else. And Julie, your husband is the best man. Eric must have the most patience of anyone. No, I've enjoyed working with you and getting to know you over the last 2 years. You kind of stole my thunder earlier, because I was going to say, people say we're cheap, but I prefer to say that we're frugal, and you said we're tightwads. So, you're right. We do think a lot alike, and we usually had our comments ended up being about the same. And, I appreciate that. But all in all, I thank everybody for the opportunity of 6 years on the board. My wife knows I'll keep talking forever. I'm sorry. I'm taking way too long. She's probably giving me the hook right now. For the incoming board members, I will, a couple of suggestions. You'll find that being on the board, you really don't get to do some of the things that you want to do. It's on the board, you're limited a lot by the law in what you can say, can do, can say, whatever it may be. I'll give you two recommendations. Of some books that I read. They were actually MSBA recommendation books. They're really quick, easy reads. One is How Not to Be a Terrible School Board Member. And has some good examples in there and pretty lighthearted reading. And the other one is The Complete Idiot's Guide to Parliamentary Procedure. And it laughed, but it just really, just the rules that you have to follow, parliamentary procedure, it can sometimes become a little bit daunting, and those books are easy books to you can download them off of Amazon or buy them off of Amazon. But I wish you three the best of luck. And I know that the school district is in good hands, and that you guys will lead us into the future. All I have.
Thank you all. I would add just as a last thought for this board, we appreciate the service of all of our board members, especially those who will be stepping away from the board. It's not an easy decision to decide to no longer serve. Once you've been doing that, it's a tough thing to step away from. And I appreciate the dedication that each one of you has put into this process to make sure that we are, as a district, are successful. And I certainly wish you all the best in whatever endeavors you choose to move forward to now, none of which could possibly be any more difficult than the service that you've had here. This is, like I said before, one of the most important things that a community does. And I appreciate all the time and effort. And I really do not believe, even after, I believe I even listed the number of hours in a communique that I sent out, I don't think anybody has any idea of how much time these folks put in. I don't think they have any clue. It's massive. Everyone in here, spouse understands that because they've had to put up with it. And I just thank you for all of your service and all of the hard work and effort and dedication that you've put in to make this district a better place. And I believe, Dr. Benson, you have some presentations to make.
Certainly. On behalf of the faculty and staff, the students, the administrators, I have recognition, a small token of our appreciation for the board members who are retiring. It's my privilege to work with these individuals. They have given me good counsel, and I appreciate their service. So with that, to William Baird from Lee Summit, our school, Board of Education Administration, 2014 through 2017, congratulations, Bill, and thank you so much. To Christopher Storms, again from the Board of Education Administration, we've got board member from 2011 through 2017 and Board of Education Vice President 15-16. And last, Terry Harmon, again from the Board of Administration, board member 2011 through 2017, Board of Education President, 14-15, Board of Education Vice President, 15-16.
And with that presentation, our current seated board retires sine die. We will resume in about 5 minutes.
Board member elects, please join Linda Ismert over at the podium.
Nobody wants to sit down. I do solemnly swear.
I do solemnly swear.
That I will support.
That I will support.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Missouri.
And the Constitution of the State of Missouri.
And that I will faithfully and impartially. Discharge the duties of school director. In and for the reorganized school district number 7. Of Jackson County. State of Missouri. To the best of my ability. According to law. Please join us at the dais.
Kim, join us right here. It's a challenge, but somebody has to see. Pursuant to traditions of LSR7, as superintendent of schools, it's my privilege to call this reorganization meeting to order and to ask for the adoption of the agenda. Do I have a motion to adopt the agenda as printed?
I move we adopt the agenda as presented.
Is there a second? Been moved and seconded that we adopt the agenda as presented. Any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor, please signify with aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. 15.02 is the election of president. Nominations do not require seconds. And at this time, I would open nominations for the election of board president. Ms. Stone.
I would like to nominate Bob White for president of the board.
Mr. Bob White has been nominated. Are there other nominations? Hearing and seeing none, I would call for nominations to be closed and for a voice vote for the election of Mr. Bob White as president for the upcoming year. All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Congratulations, Mr. White, on your election as president. The gavel is yours.
At this point, then, we will continue with our agenda. The next item, 15.03, is the election of vice president. I will entertain nominations. Adam?
Yes, Mr. President, I nominate Julie Doan for vice president of the board.
Okay, Julie Doan has been nominated for vice president of the board. Are there any other nominations? Hearing none, all those in favor of Julie Doan as vice president of the board, please signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed? Thank you very much. Congratulations, Julie. The next order of business is the election of our secretary, treasurer, and assistant secretary. There is a motion in the recommendation is in your board packet. Traditionally, we have our board secretary. It has been our Linda Ismert for all this time, Judy Hedrick as the board treasurer, Chris Eisenbinger as assistant secretary. So we will accept a motion at this point.
Happy to.
Adam?
I move that the board reappoint Linda Ismert as Secretary of the Board of Education, reappoint Judy Hedrick as Treasurer of the Board of Education, and reappoint Chris Eisenbinger as Assistant Secretary.
Okay, we have a motion and a second for Linda, Judy, and Chris to be reappointed in their positions. Do you have any discussion? All those in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Very well. Congratulations to Judy, Linda, and Chris. And that concludes the business portion of this part of the board meeting, which is usually pretty darn short. Now, the next portion is our new roundtable, and we've already done one. So please bear in mind that we've already done one roundtable. And we'll start with Jackie. We're going to start with you first.
Bottom up.
There you go.
Thank you, Linda. Linda's always helpful. Well, I want to thank Bob and Julie for their leadership, and for our other board members who are retained, Adam and Phyllis, forgive me. And I'm looking forward to working with Kim and Dennis. I've known Dennis since he was my ninth grade social studies teacher. And I won't say how many years ahead of me, but let's just say Kim graduated ahead of me. So we're looking forward to serving the community and being constructive voices for everyone touched by the district.
Thank you. Well, I was afraid I might go off the radar here, so I went ahead and wrote down what I wanted to say. I just wanted to thank the voters, especially my friends, my relatives and friends I haven't even met yet, for their confidence in me during the election. And I was truly overwhelmed with the results, and I promised to do my very best to prove a good servant to this school district, its children, its staff, and this community. And tonight, I'd especially like to thank my family for their support. My husband, Kent Pritchie, he's back there right now.
He's not asleep, Julie.
No. My parents, Bruce and Carol Headley, my mom, she's on the front row right there. My daughters are Holly, Dawn, and Natalie Santoff, and their families, including four great-grandsons, or my grandsons, her greats, Lance, Carson, Reese, and Miles. And I just wanted to say, too, it really was a pleasure meeting all of the board candidates during this process. It was pretty overwhelming that there were so many of us, but it was a great opportunity, I think, for all of us. We had lots of opportunities to get to know one another during the process, and I look forward to spending more time with some of those folks in the future, too. And just thank you all for all of your help and your encouragement.
Dennis?
I've learned from the other two. Push this button right. Okay. Yeah. Very quickly, I'd like to also thank everybody for all that they have done. I want to thank the setting board, and I want to thank the three board members who just have stepped down. And I have such Chris and Terry, many years we all sat on the CAC together, and you guys and gal, you did wonderful things. And that is such, as you spoke tonight, such a wonderful organization. It really, sometimes, I haven't done this for about 5 minutes now, but I do know the CAC really carries some real weight and does some of the heavy labor. Bill, I've learned to admire you over the course of the year. You're a great Rotarian friend, and I appreciate your support and what you've done for kids. It is also fun to see a former student, a former assistant principal of mine a few years ago, see some people out in the audience who sat in my classrooms years ago as we talked about government and how to run elections, and I taught one too well, I think, back a few months ago. But no, I look forward to working. Jeff, Don skipped out on us tonight, but the three middle school principals who we all worked together. I think it's different. I don't know if Dr. Herzog knows this or not, but you know that we used to have to be at all board meetings. I don't know. So we may have to discuss that sometime. I don't know. But again, I want to thank my wife. She knows because I've been gone most of my life doing something, and city council or coaching or those kind of things, and she's very supporting. The grandkids who live here have come out tonight. I wanted to see what a board meeting was all about, so they got to see that. But again, thank you so much. I'm looking forward to working with this group.
Julie?
Push. I want to welcome you three. We have big shoes to fill, but I like collaboration. I like teamwork, so we'll work well together. So welcome.
Adam?
Welcome. Congratulations. And it's going to be a great 3 years for you all. I just have a lot of hope and optimism and pretty high expectations, frankly, of the three of you. So I look forward to working with you.
Phyllis?
Kim and I have known for years and years. We grew up together pretty much.
Kim and I have known each other for a long time. We grew up together. We commuted our senior years for college and have cheerleaded and all that stuff together. Dennis and I have had the privilege of working. He does a mean dance. You ever want a good dance? He's got some good moves there. I've worked with him at the schools, and I don't know Jackie, but I really look forward to getting to know you, and I'm excited about the new energy on the board. So, welcome.
Dr. Benson?
I want to thank the retiring board members for their support and guidance. It was very important support and guidance as I've come in and tried to hit the ground running and be somewhat helpful in this process. Congratulations to the new board members. My role as superintendent is to try to make your lives easy, so please feel free to contact me. And finally, to the community, if you follow these taped board meetings, you know that tonight I was a little more expansive and verbose on legislative matters, and we build that towards the end of the legislative session, because the first few weeks, first couple of months of the legislative session tends to be a little feeling out process as some bills go through some hearings and get adjustments. Tonight I was more expansive and would encourage anybody to contact your legislators and let them know whether you agree with the district's position or not. It's important that legislators hear the community's voice. So thank you.
Well, I would also like to welcome our new board members. We have an interesting mix with four female board members and three male board members and two old board members. It's nice now to not be the only old person up here. So, Dennis. But actually, he's younger than I am. So, but a couple of things. First of all, we've received a challenge from Mike Dodig, who has challenged the board to participate in the trivia contest for the Lee Summit Historical Society's History Trivia Contest. I would like very much for our board to enter that, first of all, because I don't think we can lose, because probably between all of you guys, with the exception of me, there's about 480 years of experience in Lee Summit up here. So I think we ought to be able to win that. So I would like to do that. I've already talked with Linda about it, and we can participate. We'll just simply post this as a meeting like we would do with a workshop or another event that we would attend. So we can do that, and it's a public event. So I would like for you to look at your calendars, see if you happen to have April the 27th available from 6:15. That's when registration begins. But please let Linda know as soon as possible if you can participate, and we'll get a team entered. That's one thing I wanted to mention. The other thing, on a more serious note, I would challenge our entire board. As we think about elections, and we're at that part where we're looking at an election result right now, as we think about elections, we tend to think about constituencies and who our constituents are. And I want to remind, or I would challenge each board member up here to think about your ultimate constituency here as a member of the board. And because we are all elected at large, we have no particular district or anything else that we are beholden to. So in essence, my belief is the only constituency that we really have are the children of this district. So each decision that we make, please bear in mind who your constituents ultimately are. And if you can do that, I think we'll be a very successful board, and we will work towards the betterment of our community as a whole. Because our community relies very heavily on the success of our school system. And I think that is the primary piece. As much as other folks would like to think it's something else, that's the primary glue that holds our community together. And the more successful we are, the more successful our community as a whole becomes. So I would like to remind everyone that that's important. And I will leave us with that thought, and we are adjourned.